He's been utterly dominant in the first half, and with his biggest cheerleader in attendance, he's got his Chiefs ahead at the half by the score. It was Travis Kelce reminding us all he's been utterly dominant in the first half, and with his biggest cheerleader in attendance, he's got his Chiefs ahead. He's been utterly dominant in the first half, and with his biggest cheerleader in attendance, he's got. It was Travis Kelce reminding us all he's been utterly dominant in the first half, and with his biggest cheerleader in attendance.
He said that Kansas City has been surgical. Well, let me take you into the operating room where Dr. Mahomes has been doing his thing. When it comes to him and Travis Kelce, they have been playing phenomenal, and they've been moving Travis Kelce around so they can hit him everywhere. You put him in motion, you put him behind a wide receiver, and if you don't get hands on him at the line of scrimmage, then that's going to be difficult for you to stop him, because he's one of the best route runners. If it's man, he knows where body language and how he can sit there and box out a defender, and if it's zone, he knows exactly where to stop and pop in the pocket. And on top of that, my man just broke the record for the most receptions in the postseason, passing the one and only, the GOAT, Jerry Rice.
Yeah, Lamar Jackson obviously needs to have a better second half than he had in the first half, but we saw what he's capable of with that magic touchdown pass to Zay Flowers, getting out of the Rio Chenal sack, getting him open, going downfield, but they've been getting pressure on him today. Charles Amenu with a massive strip sack, Chris Jones has had some pressure as well. Lamar is going to have to step up and just make some magic happen in this second half if they're going to win this game.
And if you want to beat Patrick Mahomes, guys, you can't keep giving him second chances on that last series, obviously.